Volleyball, an incredible sport to play, especially for national ranking high school volleyball.
Chemical engineers, who are they, what are they, and why is the fire alarm on?
What about proteins, or the small amino acids that make them up?
Hi, so this is me, Daniela. Over the course of 6 years, 24 videos uploaded to my YouTube channel. It's a funny, cute moment of reflection for me. How they all captured everything I always liked about video, about storytelling, creating, and transforming education my way.
Garrett, this is a bad joke and we can't have it two times in one segment.
I first started making videos my freshman year of high school. I'm not quite sure how I got away with it. My mother and her protectiveness was always scared about my digital footprint and online predators. So I strictly made videos for class projects so she couldn't argue with me. Biology, French, engineering, government, English, chemistry. Whenever I either was asked to or given the option to, I made a video for any creative project. I didn't want to be an academic in any way.
Please tune in soon whenever I can figure out how many characters I'm playing at once.
Video making for my assignments was a huge thrill. I was really proud to share them in front of the class. My videos were professional, yet making do with what I had. I grew up with pretty low resources, so no professional cameras, no paid editing software, and that was pretty hard to get away with 5 years ago. Today, video production is a hell of a lot easier, and everyone has an iPhone and iMovie and knows what quote-unquote good videos are supposed to look like. But making do with technology I had then was my form of empowerment in the way. See, I watched a lot of YouTube as a kid, and especially at maybe 12 through 14, I found myself in this whole sector of science and alternative educational video content. I'd watch chemistry, physics, math, science videos that would use film and animation to simplify complicated topics.
Up exactly. This sounds pretty nice. I like the chemistry. Yes, very. Yes.
In video, science was entertainment. It was on a test or a textbook or a lecture. It was dynamic and thoughtful story. I love science to this day because watching and creating video redefined for me what learning looks like. This spring semester, I took a Technology, Society, and Education course with Dr. Chanel Wilson, where we ask ourselves, what does today's classroom look like with technology? This question lends itself to recent times, as the internet and digital tools have an overwhelming amount of influence in our everyday lives, especially when COVID-19 has massively changed our online world. Students these days are constantly exposed to information on the internet, far more than what I grew up with. Via video games, social media, YouTube, TikTok, in the past decade, digital media has overfilled us with information. Entertainment and education are merging together. So while in tech and ed, we talk about how digital tools improve the classroom, I also see an argument that digital tools have shifted the classroom into non-traditional spaces. Students these days are more digitally literate than ever. So their assessments and artifacts of their learning should reflect the media that inspires them to learn outside the classroom. This doesn't mean that all students come to the table with equal access to technology or experience, or that mainstream digital media and content creators create stories that encompass all intersectional identities. The online world is still reflective of our racialized world, where discrimination and inequity are rampant in how information is distributed. By teaching students how to use online tools, we're preparing students to be digital citizens, responsible and having ownership of what they do and say on the internet. Students are not just bystanders, but actively engaging and criticizing all the information they see. 6 years of video have shown me how fast my education has changed alongside the technology I used. Whereas I only thought these videos were purely for fun, they served as an homage to the digital world I was influenced by. I took intellectual ownership about the content I studied and invited myself to study something that wasn't necessarily built for me, but the content I saw told me that it was. I look forward to see how younger generations of students are able to produce with their own enriched exposure to digital media. Offering alternative assessments using these digital tools can drastically impact how we qualitatively assess learning. All students should have access to an education that fosters curiosity and responsibility about what they learn. So, digital literacy and learning that way is that form of empowerment. And it sticks around. I think at least it did for me.